We understand why they're doing it. We just question their methods.
The mission is to clear hurricane debris from canals in Cape Coral, but neighbors say crews are destroying habitats around the canals in the process. People are worried burrowing owls and gopher tortoises are getting caught up in the cleanup.
The city says 20 crews are out every day, and all this work should be done by April. NBC2's Jennifer Vegas in the southwest part of the Cape right now, showing us what canals look like when the cleaning crews are done.
Neighbors here on Southwest 20th Ave tell me 4 months ago, this canal looked very different. It was lined with trees. Tonight, it's nearly barren with just a few tree stumps and grass stalks.
So we have bunnies, we have gopher turtles, we have burrowing owls are very prosperous where we are here in the Cape.
But neighbors and local environmentalists fear this is the beginning of the end.
So just seeing it in action is kind of, it's concerning.
Darcy Johnson lives in the Southwest Cape. Yesterday, driving around, she noticed big changes in her neighborhood.
Now you can see straight through when you're driving.
Now, those trees are cut down, sitting in piles along the curb to be picked up by claw trucks and heading to the landfill.
Something has to change, and this is a desperate situation.
Cheryl Anderson with Cape Coral Friends of Wildlife says Johnson isn't alone.
We're having people call our hotline 3 and 4 times a day as they're watching this destruction happen in front of their eyes.
It's all part of the city's canal debris cleanup operation launched in November. Every day, sending out 20 contracted crews, most land-based, to clean up vegetation, construction, and demo debris on our canals using heavy machines. Anderson believes crews are taking out healthy trees with dead or invasive vegetation.
So they're bulldozing across lots, and then they are removing all of the vegetation, not just debris that fell in, right? All of the vegetation that is on the banks.
Anderson hopes the city considers taking a less aggressive approach.
Now the city expects crews will be finished clearing out all this debris by April. I'm local in Cape Coral, Jennifer Vegas, NBC2.